It's January 19, 9:11 a.m., 2019. This is going to be a video, people, to expound more about our situation. And it's going to be a video to really get you to understand the infallibleness of God and how I know God is at work. Do you hear this out here? The rain and the winds and those chimes. Those are sounds that heal you, okay? Thunder is healing. All those sounds are healing sounds. Those are white noises. But I'm not going to get off the subject here of how do you know you're dealing with an aspect or an advanced aspect of God or Godhead. For one, Roger Colley can't stand injustice, okay? Roger Colley hates injustice no matter what and who is doing it. There is no bias or discrimination concerning the injustice. All right? And that is one of the things that I can't stand. And I know an injustice has been done to me. And it didn't matter whether God spoke to me through some little voice saying, oh, you must. It didn't matter. Because an advanced soul is not going to tolerate certain things. No matter who is trying to get them or persuade them to go against what they know they're not like, okay? With this said, we do have technology in place that you really actually don't have a free will, but it is actually about your choices, all right? So when you find yourself in these roles that they put you in, they watch, these watchers. When you're in these bad roles or play this bad role and you don't do anything to rectify it or change it, and you don't have any remorse for it, you're showing that you're an inhuman type person. And the kingly law really is to love your neighbor as you love yourself, okay? So if your neighbor has wronged you or you've wronged your neighbor, don't you try to do something to rectify it, to make it right? That's the kingly law. You understand? God is not partial. God does not harp on someone's wrongdoing constantly. God looks for the good in people, or to see if they can be, if their goodness will outdo their badness. And in this case, they continually wanted to do what was bad by trying to cover up the sex trafficking and pedophilia ring, and I'm outraged behind it. Outraged. Because what do you do when law enforcement is your problem? When law and order is the problem? Who know how you truly are and has spread bad things about you so that they can be on top, or so that they can appear righteous. What do you do when that's the case? Because that's the case here. Roger Colley hates injustice. That's how these higher authorities up there in the cosmos know that I am what I am. Because even being killed or harmed, I will not back down to this type of tyranny. I can't stand it. And with that said, how are you going to rectify yourself if you found yourself in a bad way, because Jody's uneven when been baptized. That's how I know this is a simulation. I've been baptized at a place called Healing Church. Healing place. I'm all about healing. What they did not long ago proved that they had evil intent here. Why would the neighbor offer me a 50-pound fish to eat? That was supposed to be me, 50 pounds, a little 9-year-old. Or 10 years old, I think I was 50 pounds at 10. Why would Russ Warwick says the fish stinks from the head? I smell something. The fish stinks from the head. If these are not jinn or nephilims, okay, that I'm dealing with. Offering me a 50-pound fish, the neighbor did, to eat. They kept mocking. Listen to that sound, people. That's pretty. Look at this. See my rug? Look at this. I want to show you all these things. When I told you about the spider webs and all that, I ain't lying about that. And this is something a little girl made, and I kept it on my door. Her name is Jamaica. She had open heart surgery. And she's still alive, poor little girl. But this is about not having, about loving your neighbor as you love yourself. And when you find out that you've wronged your neighbor, you need to rectify it in simple ways. You don't continue to try to have them living a lie or be trapped in something so that they can steal all of your essence or soul belongings. Now, when I told y'all about the spider webs, let's see if you can see that. Can you see it? I'm showing y'all things so you can see. When I'm telling you, I know they done worked some serious craft here. Look at that. And I know who's done it because they're not totally human. And they are, let me see what else I can show you. Yeah, listen, look at this. See? See what they've done here? Look at that. And with this said, knowing that I've been battling in y'all abyss, my hubby needs to come and fix this trailer. How would he need to do? He needs to come do work on my trailer, since y'all didn't want to pay him for fixing on trailers. That's what Yellow Jacket was all about. Not just about workers, but Yellow Jacket was about actual Yellow Jacket wasps that had lived in this, all over this trailer. Red wasps, actually. But Yellow Jacket was because y'all refused to pay Mr. Mayor Vardan for the work he was doing over there in France. Y'all worked him like a dog, huh? He shouldn't have played with me like this. Look at that. Why did you play with me, Mayor Vardan? The sages told you not to play with me, and I know you were playing with me because you was laughing, and I had said it. I said, look at you, you nice little actor you are. I know what you're doing, and it's time now that you come and make amends. That's what you do. Because Jody is not ever going to go for pedophilia. How I know y'all was working a Pancha Makara ritual on here is because my poor little friend, that little Tiffany over there, was doing all that laughing without, nobody knew why she was laughing like a mad woman. And I knew, after I read about what this is, about how they can do this with this esoteric Tibetan Buddhism, okay? So I knew a Pancha Makara ritual was being done. Y'all think I'm stupid. Jody's not stupid. I am dealing with the real forces of God. And these sounds that you hear out here, baby, these are healing sounds. There's no need for y'all to be under no anymore. What they call this? See? Hubby, you need to come fix my trailer. That's right. Jai Ho Ram, come fix this trailer. Now come do what you need to do, because you was trying to get here and they ran their software. See this Anon stuff, QAnon? I just watched the movie last night. Look at the poor dog. They named this dog DJ because of my... Things are going to add up. Hey, DJ, he's a very sick dog. Ron Piangel, I saw that black dog you sent in when you was trying to switch the timeline. See, I'm aware of what you with some of the things that's being done that y'all aren't aware of. Well, anyway, this Nahusha 10 ain't nothing but a gin. And if you look at the 9/11, when those towers went down, all that smoke, who came out of there? Those were gin that y'all saw in the smoke. Do y'all understand this? Y'all were looking at gin. Okay? And I am injured with this technology to the point where some of this, a backlash happened because I had already taken down your matrix. I put myself in it and slammed it. And you cannot continue to do this to me, try to erase evidence of what my life course really is. You don't attack someone that is in their bed sleeping and come through and hold them down and attack them. I was minding my own business. How was I doing anyone anything? Huh, law enforcement? How was I doing anyone anything, Freemason Templars, who want your gray state when you yank me up into another dimension and hook me in my spinal column? That's how these insecticides got involved, to try to repair my spinal column. And that's kind of like one of the reasons you see all these spider webs here. Because their energy has been here. I stood out in my yard. And all of the insecticide beings, I couldn't see them clearly, but they were speaking to me. I mean loud, and they were scared. And they were sorry. They were telling me they were sorry. And when I said, you are forgiven, I understand why you did this, just go. It's okay. Go. They went away. So it is about forgiving when you can forgive, when it's necessary to forgive. But how can you forgive an outright Nephilim who wants to mock God by harming God's counterpart? And had him on the software jerking off where he's... In my mind, I never heard it, but I was allowed to hear it, where y'all are using him to make jerk-off noises on me, or my energy as filth. And Mardi Gras coming up, people. And they know what those king cakes are really about? I just realized that this morning. They always have a baby in the king cake. That's not a good thing. Mother Kali is wearing babies on her ears because of people having a taste to eat babies. To eat fetuses or eat my babies so that they can have power. Some call it adrenochrome. But the technology, I'm going to be real serious and straight with you. the technology that was used on this road 10 years ago is called, it's Orion Tech, and they call it the Love Bite, okay? It will create a scenario that isn't real. It's called Orion Tech, and it creates a love bite where it gives you a spell or something of being in love with someone you're not really in love with, alike, okay? A lot of you are put with people that really aren't your true companions, but you might have some soul work you're doing with them. And how serious this is I have even become aware of how some of the old stars, you know, stars that once lived have died, and y'all have used their personality and incorporated in these people here. You sure have. You've incorporated my, what is her name? That blonde woman? Marilyn Monroe. She's been incorporated into several people. Vivian Leigh has been incorporated into several women. Y'all have done some serious satanic stuff. And I was told that this woman in the South who owned all this land, that's who I was. And I never felt that in myself. So I laid down and I meditated. And why did God show me who she was? And it wasn't me. It was an old Creole woman over with a church. She was dealing with a church, okay? Civil rights lady or something. And I saw that. I said, so that's who they trying to say is me. No. Who I am is Brother Kali, okay? Kushananda. And when I went to Cafe Brazil and y'all did all that and shot those lights at me, that was another me, and closed those mirrors and cameras on me. I did some research about Kushananda, Mata Kushananda. And that is the woman who smiles. And I'm like, is that what happened? I closed my eyes and I smiled. I smiled because I was fed up, but I didn't know that she's the one who creates the suns, who lives in the sun. And you're going to find out that's all I used to draw when I was little, suns. Orange and yellow suns all the time. You know? So, this is being undone, people. A lot of high-level people that are in the know are undoing it because they know I'm fed up. And I'm hoping my hubby gets here and he comes and fixes his trailer. Yellow jacket, huh? Y'all should have paid him for working. That's right. Donald Trump and your Trump Towers. Yes, your Trump CERN Towers, huh? You got your CERN puppet over there. He worked for you. Just like I know Montegraph works for the Boston mob. All right, FBI. Time for y'all to undo this. And for the truth to be really seen and known. About how y'all try to hijack Lil Jody. Your seven spirits that when sent out into the earth are seven Jinn kings who have no crown. This is a bunch of sorcery and witchcraft and voodoo being undone. Trust me.